So guys, we are officially down 20 pounds in 1 month.
272 to 251.0.
Yeah. But we're still making consistent progress, which is exactly what we want.
I mean, testosterone is the most anabolic hormone in the body. I gotta have my own testosterone.
Right.
High as possible. That could boost your test levels. If you get enough sleep, that could boost your test levels. If you don't run your body, you know, into the ground, the oxidative stress, over and over and over without maximizing recovery, that could decrease your test levels.
It's been a lot of fun, and it just shows that it's not so difficult, man. It's just a matter of consistency.
Yeah.
And, you know, and staying true to yourself and staying true to your goals, you know, and not allowing any distractions to get in the way, because if you can do just that, then the progress will be there. All right, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back. This is episode 5 of the All In Transformation with my man, Nick Del Toro. So guys, we are officially down 20 pounds in 1 month. It's absolutely crazy.
272 to 251.0.
Yeah, so basically 20.6.
20.6.
Total pounds in 1 month. So we wanted to break down a few things for you guys, just so you guys understood what is it that we did to get to this point. So actually, Nick has been extremely easy to work with. We haven't really changed anything about his diet. It's been consistent. You know, the initial week, you're gonna drop a little bit. You know, you're gonna get a little bit of that extra water, especially if we've been eating, you know, kind of like, you know,
some bullshit.
Yeah, having some fun foods, your body's gonna retain a little bit. So we did have, you know, a significant drop to begin with. And then as we've kind of followed each week, which was normal, exactly what I told him was gonna happen. It was gonna kind of slow down a little bit, but we're still making consistent progress, which is exactly what we want, which is why I haven't really done anything to his diet up until really at all yet. The only thing that I've been doing was every weekend we inserted some refeeds. So I was giving him like extra bit of carbs, whether it be 50 to 100 grams of carbs. When he actually took a trip to Austin this weekend.
Oh, yeah.
And this was a big milestone because Nick likes to drink a little bit of wine sometimes.
Yeah. Just socialize.
Yeah.
Socialize and then go out. And that's my only, I would say, vice when it comes, because I mean, I don't do drugs. I don't gamble. I don't, have a car hobby or anything that's super expensive, but I do like to go out, be outdoors, drink and eat.
Yeah.
So
the one thing that I felt was like a major milestone for Nick was having to, when you do go out and socialize with friends that, you know, because Nick told me when he drinks, he likes to drink. So it's like,
nothing kind of a thing.
If you're going to feel it, then you're really going to feel it. And I think for him, you know, being able to limit that alcohol consumption, still be able to go out with friends and have a few drinks. I mean, that's what it's all about, guys. You know, it's all about balance.
But mind you, I kind of had in mind that I was going to do this. So I limited some carbs from every meal. And then that last meal, of course, I didn't have any carbs. I had two skinny margaritas and then a fillet of tuna. So
perfect. Yeah. And that's what you do is you just kind of like alter the diet. You know, because basically you would know how many calories are within the beverage, and you can be able to pull away from the calories within your food for that day, and it will make up for it, so that the damage isn't necessarily so great. And then, you know, you feel like you're involved in within the group and whatnot.
Yeah.
Like I mentioned, we didn't change anything with his diet. So basically his overall macros have stayed relatively consistent. We kept his protein high. His protein is around like 270 grams. His carbs are about the same. On his high carb days though, we increased it to about 350 for the day. Another thing also with the workouts, you know, maximizing those workouts.
Okay, we talk about arms now?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So what are the like 5 keys to today's workout?
Man, so mind to muscle connection being number one. The mental aspect of it is going to be huge. And this is one thing that I was having Nick really, really try to emphasize is that think about the contraction and you know, be able to slow everything down so that way you're really being able to stimulate the muscle as much as you possibly can. Because a lot of times, you know, what I was finding Nick doing was just kind of really kind of going through the motions sometimes.
I was guilty. Yeah.
You know, and it happens.
You don't know it. Then when he had to check me like 3 times. And then finally, it's like, okay, I'm not doing something right. So I really just connected with it. I was like, from the beginning, I felt it that much more, at least 10, 20% more.
Oh, absolutely. And you're actually going to find that the muscle taxes much quicker, right? So you're not going to be able to do as much, but the overall work that the muscle is receiving is much, much higher, which you will feel. You're gonna tax yourself. You're gonna basically hit failure at a much lower repetition.
But it's kind of counterintuitive. Growing up in the age of, you know, nothing against the Branch Warrens and the Ronnie Comans, but growing up in that age, the bigger the number on the barbell or dumbbell equals the more amount of work that you're doing, the better you're gonna, you know, the more results you're gonna get, and that is not the case with everybody.
No, so no. I personally, as you guys can see with the training videos that we've been putting out, I like to focus on concentration. I like to focus on perfect form and just maximizing the lift, being able to really just focus on that muscle group. So like today, but with being biceps and triceps, you know, really being able to think through the lift, because we were able to tax him out, you know, a lot sooner than he would have really anticipated if he was to have gone through the workout himself. Because prior to the workout, you know, he was asking me what the workout was going to be like, and he's like, wow, that's it. And I'm like, trust me, when we're done, we're done.
Yeah, but I mean, that is so counterintuitive. It's like you have to relearn it and be efficient and just zap the muscle. You know what I mean?
Efficiency.
Yeah.
Efficiency is the number one key, guys. And that's what you want to make sure that you're doing when you're in the gym. You don't want to waste your time. You should be able to finish a good solid workout within 45 to 60 minutes maximum. All right. So everything is building up to that final really working set. So we're hitting, you know, 3 to 4 working sets, but the last one is the key. That's the one that we want to really give all out effort into, because that's what's going to make the most difference.
The stimulus right there.
Right. And you can't do that with every single set. So just keep that in mind that, you know, we want to work up to that last set.
Let's go. Full extension. Good. Full extension.
Yeah.
Good. All right. Drop the band. Drop the band. Keep going. Yeah.
Come on.
One more. One more. Right there. Drop it. Drop it. Again. Drop it again. Hold it. Hold it. Drop it. One clip.
So we had the mind-muscle connection as one, and then the variety of exercise. You had me, for biceps, just straight up barbell curls. You had one where I could get a full stretch in it, the incline dumbbell curls, and then the last one with the preacher curls.
Yep.
And then with the lying tricep extensions, the full, I guess, the long head.
Right.
And then the banded dips, and then we did push-downs.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, you have to have all of those movements, it's a different function of the muscle, you know, and you move in a different way. So what is the importance of having that variety?
Man, the variety is going to be key, because that way, especially when there is multiple heads, you want to be able to hit every single one of them and kind of emphasize on each group. So what I like to do is, like, you know, with triceps, we started off with a rope extension. That's just going to be an easy exercise to be able to kind of follow through, get a nice pump, you know, warm that muscle up pretty well. And then we moved on to a heavier compound lift, which was going to be the skull crusher. But we did dumbbells. The dumbbells allows us to have a greater range of motion. It allows us to be a bit more free within the movement. You're not, and it really, I feel like it's a lot easier on the wrist, because sometimes when you're using that cambered bar, if the bar is not, like, properly set up in a way, like as far as like where the curve is within it, I feel like it tends to hurt. Like the last time we filmed an arm workout, you're like, that's what happened to me. I was going a bit too heavy, and I actually felt it in my wrist a lot more than I really should have. So with this, that's what I wanted him to do, was just to be able to use that the dumbbells there. He felt that really, really well. And then we finished off with the last one, was a bodyweight exercise, but we used the band, so that way you can add some extra resistance.
Never done that before. I felt it big time.
Right. So, you know, if you have the belt, you can use the belt with the waist, but the band was nice because it just keeps it simple, and then you're essentially just using, you know, what you have. For the biceps, like you mentioned, we start off with a heavy movement with the barbell curl. And that was just, you know, straight barbell curl there. We built up. You know, once again, we warmed them up, and then we got them to the 8 to 10 working set range. And then we finished off with the drop set on the final set. Second exercise, we went to the incline dumbbell curl. With that, we kept it completely supinated throughout. This is where I was really having him focus on that mind and muscle connection and allowing the biceps to do all the work, right? Obviously, with the last set, we pretty much pushed him to failure, which is what we want to do, like I mentioned to you guys earlier. And then the last exercise, we finished off with the preacher curl with the machine. What I like about that prime machine is that you can really change the emphasis of the contraction is with that muscle. We kept it where it was relatively centered. And then once again, got him into that 8 to 10 working range as far as the working sets. And then we finished him off a hardcore double drop set and just really taxing the muscle out completely. So that way, whenever I say he was done, he was done. And that pretty much, you know, toasted him completely. He's going to feel this workout tomorrow. And the best thing about it was efficiency. We finished off pretty quickly, right? It's gonna be tough, you know, but at the end of the day, guys, like, you have to dig deep. You have to be able to dig deep. And if you want change, if you want results, you know, it takes work. You know, you can't just sit here and just go through the motions. You have to push yourself. You have to ask more from your body, and your body will give it to you. But it's just like, you know, It's not gonna be easy. But if you can get in there, if you can push yourself mentally, there's gonna be so many changes. This is where muscle growth happens, even while we're in a deficit. You're gonna continue to see Nick's body change as we continue crushing these workouts, continue bringing down his body fat. I'm really excited for this process. You know, we're just getting started. We're only a month in. And like I mentioned to you guys in a couple episodes before, that results may vary, all right? So, you know, it's like the way where we've been, I'm a lot more hands-on with him, so I'm able to really, really see and implement changes as we go. So it makes the process a lot easier for Nick. Is there anything else you want to finish off with?
No, I just wanted to reiterate your mind-muscle connection. It's huge.
Yep.
And then the variety. And then that fail set, that gritty set where you really generate the stimulus for the muscle to respond. But then it's like, okay, so what's a progression with this? It's like, okay, we have all these things down, but I mean, the name of the game is to continually overload so you can.
Right.
So it's like you kind of just reiterate what you said before.
Yep.
Whether it be more weight, more reps, less rest, yada yada. Is this kind of, or do we follow one general progression guideline?
No. So like what we'll do is obviously the next working, the next arm day, we'll take what we were able to do here. I know exactly what weights we use, so we can see whether or not he's increased his overall power and load. We can increase the weight and see where his progression is there. You know, and typically that's what I'd like to do, you know, even if it's like just an extra 1%, right? So if it's an additional, let's say an additional rep or two per working set, you know, I think that'll be kind of the key. And then again, we can monitor the overall rest periods. And then just kind of see, like, because if we can be able to continue to get more reps with the same weight, then we know that we're progressing. And then from there, we can be able to increase the weight over time.
Yes, sir. So I need to keep my test levels high, my cortisol levels low,
yep,
and my mind-muscle connection strong and continually progress.
That's it. That's Easy. It, man. Let's keep working hard, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. If you did, make sure you guys give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channels. And until next time, everyone, peace out.